Hello everyone, my dear students. Today's topic is cognitive development of Jean Piaget. So before going to the theory of cognitive development, we should know what cognition is. Cognition, it refers to the inner process and product of the mind which leads us to knowing. Knowing through attending, remembering, symbolizing, categorizing, planning, reasoning, problem solving, creating and fantasizing. So while going to the theory of cognitive development, Jean Piaget became a cognitive theorist by observing his own three children. He presumed that every child born in the world around acquired the knowledge of environment, be it in the terms of exploring, discovering and even constructing the stimulus through his or her own activities. Piaget also believed that children take an active role in learning process. They make observations and learn. As they interact with the world around them, continually they add new knowledge, build upon existing knowledge, and adapt previously held ideas to accommodate new information. Before, we used to say that children are the adult's miniature, but it was Piaget who said that children think differently from the adults. He also said that the intelligence of the children or the person or the human grows and develops through a series of stages. So the cognitive stages given by Jean Piaget has four stages, which we say first is sensory motor stage, that is from 0 to 2 years. Pre-operational stage, that is from 2 to 7 years, and concrete operational stage, that is 7 to 11 years, and formal operational stage, that is 12 above. Number one, that is sensory motor stage. Through the word itself, we can know that it is about the senses and the motors. Senses, which means the five senses, and motors, which means the movement. The child knows the world through their movements and senses. They understand the world by coordinating the sensory experiences with the physical actions, which means reflexes, senses and motor responses. The main hallmark of this stage is object permanence. As an example, we can say that child before this stage, that is 2 years of age, they do not have the object permanence, which means the things which are not in front of them or which are not in the front of their eyes, they are not, or they do not exist, or they are not there. Example, if we saw a child a toy or a car before 2 years of age, and if we hide them for a movement, they think that they do not search for them, as they think that they do not exist. But at the end of the stage, that is about 2 years age, if we do the same thing, if we show a toy or a car or a ball, and if we hide for the movement, they come for searching, which means they know that the things which are not in front of their eyes also, they exist. Number two, that is pre-operational stage. Pre-operational stage is from 2 to 7 years old. And this pre-operational stage also we can divide into two parts. That is pre-conceptual stage, that is from 2 to 4 years. And intuitive phase, that is to 4 to 7 years. In pre-conceptual stage, the child starts to learn about the concept. They just starts or they just begin to understand the concepts. They know the objects, identify them by names and put into class and groups. This is the stage where they start the thinkings and the reasoning, but it is illogical. There is no reason behind them. It's illogical. Third is, in this stage, they have the egocentric nature. Egocentric means that the child thinks that the world around him, that may be physical or that may be inhuman, that exists only for him. He or she fails to understand or struggles to think, or they struggle to understand things from the other's perspective. Next is intuitive phase, that is 4 to 7 years old. And intuition, from the word itself, we can say that it is intuitional and rather than the logical one. They do not have the logic. The development starts the thinking process and the reasoning power starts, but it's illogical in this stage. Next, in intuitive phase, that is from 4 to 7 years of age, reasoning powers develops, but it is only about the physically present objects. Abstractly, they cannot think or they cannot reason. Next is, in this stage, they have the absence of reversibility and conservation. Reversibility means they cannot understand the concept of reversibility. As an example, we can say that there are two childs, and we ask the child, the younger one, which is in this stage, if we ask the child that do you have a sister or a brother, she can say, yes, I have a sister or a brother. But again, we reverse the question, like, your sister or brother has a sister or a brother, he or she cannot answer, as they do not have this capability or their cognitive development doesn't exist of this reversibility. Next is conservation. In conservation, as an example, we can say that we have a two container of a same size, same breadth, and we pour a water of equal volume. If we ask the child of this stage, then he or she may say that yes, there is the same amount or the same volume of water in it. And if we pour the water into a third container, which may be longer in size but shorter in breadth, and if we pour the same amount of the water, same volume of the water, and we ask the same question again, the child will say that the longer bottle or the third container has the equal amount of the more volume of the water, as they do not have the conservation. Next, the main hallmark of this stage is language development. The third stage, that is the concrete operational stage, 7 to 11 years. Here the child begins to think logically about concrete events. They begin to understand the concept of conservation and reversibility. They are more logical and organized. They begin using inductive reasoning from specific information to the general principles. Here in this stage, the egocentrism of previous stage begins to disappear, but the children of this stage tend to struggle with abstract and hypothetical concepts. The last stage, that is formal operational stage, that is 11 years and above. Here the child begins to think abstractly and reason more about hypothetical problems. Here they begin to think more about moral, philosophical, ethical, social, and political issues that requires theoretical and abstract reasoning. They begin to use deductive logic or reasoning from a general principle to a specific information. In this stage, there is an increase in logic, the ability to use deductive reasoning, and an understanding of abstract ideas. They become more capable of seeing multiple potential solutions to problems and think more scientifically about the world around them. So this is how Piaget theory of cognitive development has divided the stages into four parts: sensory motor, pre-operational, concrete, and formal operational stages.